Ashtar 2022 and its potentials. Greetings, family. It's good to be here again. We're on a new big marker. You have once again managed to pass through a large door. So many times, they who try, have desired your annihilation. They have tried, but without success, to undo your progress so many times, and with no good results for them. At most, some delays that ended up helping us in our dynamics. My dear Earth Confederates, representatives of the highest spiritual host of determined beings. Yes, to get where you are, it takes more than will, determination is required at all levels. You have gone through, and are still going through, one of your greatest trials while in this physical environment, but that is already over. You will perceive that soon. I said at the beginning of the year 2021 that you would be safer and that you would face challenges, many of you, but you would be safe and confident in yourselves, above all, and that nothing was going to bring you down and, well, here you are, again, in body and spirit, for another year of your stories on Earth. It's been a challenging year, especially for those of you who are ahead, I know. My beloved channel knows this, right? Come on, breathe. Take a break and let's resume. This last year, dear ones, has put you to the test on so many levels, and I've said this before. I told you it would be like this, but look, look how much you have expanded emotionally. See how much you gave up on things that no longer made sense to you. Quite a bit. For some of you, I know it was extremely difficult to let go of old patterns, but you did. And here we are at the doors of 2022, as a year that I will call the Great Portal of Crossing. Yes, my dears, this is the year of the Great Crossing. And don't be alarmed when I say that there will be many souls that will return home this year, not because some apocalypse will occur, not because of that, but simply because it's their time. I said this before and you asked me if it's because of the current viral situation, and I told you no. I will talk more about this later on. This will be the year, too, with the highest number of births of human beings ever recorded, and you will be able to see that at its close. Why? Because it's the beginning of humanity's ultimate shift to the new track, the full regeneration track. More star seeds are ready to incarnate from the most diverse and varied sectors of the galaxy and beyond. There will be many births of twins, triplets, quadruplets. Moms and dads, get ready. There is great preparation on the spiritual planes at this time for these descents. Many of you, who are physically holding this light on the planet right now, have also been instrumental in this. You've been very demanding this year because you've had to hold more light than, as I would say, normal. Why? Well, you know all the terror that has been cast upon you, all the emotional chaos that global society has experienced due to the viral trap thrown. While many went into emotional despair, you had to balance and anchor more light so that a minimum of balance was present, so that those who wish for your annihilation would not have absolute success. And here we are to say that you have once again managed to nullify extermination. And while they try to make your planet aware of their mission failures, I, personally, am in charge of capturing them and bringing them aboard the Grand Ethical Council of the Galaxy. I already told you to leave it to me. I will honor that part. None of them will leave the planet on escape routes, either through its north and south poles, or through any other portal anywhere on the planet. I've even tasked my team with monitoring every strategic exit, and an escape is absolutely impossible. In the meantime, enjoy the feeling of accomplishment, in the certainty that they will not be able to go beyond what they have already been, no matter how hard their propaganda keeps trying. It's useless. This is a year in which you will also be asked for faith. Faith in others, in your brothers and sisters, faith in the Supreme Creator, faith in us and, above all, faith in yourself. You will need to believe more in yourself, in your own potentials, in your own expanding capabilities. Quantum therapists, this will be your year. This is the year in which you will be extremely called to work, more than ever. Emotional and spiritual health will need to be adjusted and you will be sought after on all levels, physical and etheric, as many souls who leave their bodies will also seek you out to cross over to the more subtle planes. And here's something interesting. Have you noticed more noises, at night, when you go to sleep or in the middle of the night? Well, that's interesting. It's a sign of the intertwining of dimensions. Yes, there is this crossover dimension and the dimensional veil that separates the dimensions is thinning a lot, and this year will be thinner than ever. Don't be scared. It's part of it. Just as you on the physical plane will be more easily seen by those of other parallel dimensions, so a ghost in the middle of the night may well not be a ghost, but another version of yourself. This is part of the dimensional unification process. This is the way, this is your future. The merging of yourselves into the greater self. But I also need to say that they could be souls in search of your loving directions. Have patience and love with them. They see it as portals of light. As I recently told you in a previous message I delivered to this channeler about updating her DNA, this will continue, of course, and other tweaks beyond, as in the big feed of your three brains. This will be more intense in 2022 because it is also the year of alignment, not by chance. Another point that this new year will continue to bring to you is the need for adjustments in your relationships, be they affective, family, friendly. You will have to complete the unfinished and you will inevitably be drawn towards it. In the last 2 years, you have already been forced to an approximation of your loved ones by staying more time indoors, with their families face to face, under the same roof and, well, you know. A lot of things came to light, didn't they? They were things kept that seemed to have already been finished and, all of a sudden, hua, there they are being discussed. Well, that also needed to happen, for you cannot cross the great portal towards your ascension, and that is not our rule. It is something that you yourselves have determined. It's something of you, and that's great. Clean house for new experiences. So let's go. Get to work. Pick up the phone if necessary. Call anyone who feels the need to adjust a few things. If there is still any discomfort, anger, resentment, hurt or anything like that, or simply meditate lovingly connecting with the universal forces, so that the universe promotes the synchronicities for these adjustments. And believe me, it will happen one way or another, and it needs to happen for your own emotional and physical health. Your bodies can no longer bear emotional burdens, traumas, hurts, your livers need to release anger, their esophagus and throats need to release the revolts and anguish. It's about time. Many of you have been experiencing pain lately, pain that even the most sophisticated tests in your laboratories cannot resolve. You feel it, you go to the doctor, they ask for tests and, well, there's nothing there, absolutely nothing they can explain to you. Then they resort to the quantum, new age therapists, here you come in once again. Well, here are the explanations. Past traumas, emotional stress, spiritual obsessions due to low vibration attunements, fears, insecurities, angers, etc. Or are they simply your body's efforts to adapt to the new vibrations of light, the sacred codes that come from the center of galaxy, and that light descends opening space, completely, in all the blocked zones. This can also cause them some physical discomfort and the more resistance to these receptions, the more uncomfortable for the simple fact that it is something necessary, and for your own good. You've heard this before. The more you resist, the harder it is. So let it flow. Let go of what needs to go away, release the burdens, forgive, forgive yourself, love and love yourself. Release the old ways, the old customs and open yourself to something that is innate to you, love. You are not there to learn to love, but to remember love. Because you forgot it. The traumas of life on the planet have made you forget, and every effort of the light to help you is to remind you again of who you are and your potential, dear ones. And yes, it will often hurt. Hurt to the point where they think they are getting sick, but no. This could be the light asking for passage. After a long time in the dark, when you see the light you will feel great discomfort in your eyes, but you will soon get used to it and merge into the light. And that's what will happen. This is what is happening right here, right now, in this moment. Let's talk about the planet itself. Yes, the Earth will undergo necessary adjustments in 2022, but once again, don't be alarmed. That's part of it too. The Pacific Ocean will be more active this year. Coastal areas, beware. Attentive to the signs of nature, the skies, and the seas themselves. The recalibration of Gaia's body continues, as does every human body. The planet's Kundalini will be in intense activity, and this could bring volcanic upheavals on the old continent. We are also present to minimize and slash or even nullify some more intensive effects, where possible. The highest sensitivity ranges are being monitored by our best stellar scientists, sidereal engineers, and physicality specialists. These are processes that just as your bodies are releasing certain energies, so will Gaia be. It is something necessary. Essential, actually. Just have faith. Trust. It's all right. This will also be the year in which we take another step towards you, and I hasten to say again that, not as your saviors, but as your friends of eons. And obviously, we're taking that step because you're taking it too when you trust, love, and dedicate yourself. Dear ones, when you can see, when you give yourself the opportunity to feel beyond your five senses, you will very clearly perceive a powerful universe of endless love within you. An inexhaustible and powerful source that will guide you to unlimited peace and abundance. You are getting there. Never forget that it can often seem like nothing is changing, and again I invite you to look back 10 years, where were you? What were you doing? What was your level of consciousness at the time? Is there anything you wouldn't do again today that you did 10 years ago? Yes. I know so, and so do you. This is evolution. It's consciousness expansion, and you can't deny it. I am very happy with this moment for our brief message. Your DNA is being updated at an accelerated rate. This is pretty obvious, I know. How much has been going on while this is happening, you know. Everything was programmed. This is a time of rebirth for you. Many things are being released from your Akashic, memories, feelings, visions, emotions, everything has to come for you to look at. You need to look. You will no longer be able to keep it inside. I have warned about this in my most recent posts. It's your time to look deeply at yourself. Nothing else will be hidden in your unconscious. I want to talk a little about the old prophecies. My dears, much is said about the end of time and how it will happen. Obviously, over the centuries, you've been brought to the most varied versions of what this would be like, from the fiery apocalypse to the floods, and even the vicious alien invasion. Oh dear ones! How many times do we need to say that the Creator does not want your annihilation and that we are here to guarantee it? God's love for you is much greater than you can even imagine. He loves you without limits and we are here as witnesses of that truth. Oh! A meteor will come and destroy the planet. Oh no! We are here patrolling your skies, your solar system. Do you really think this would happen, randomly? Or do you think that if such a celestial body came towards you for its annihilation, we would not intervene? We've done this before, my dears. Search your social media. You will see videos of us in action keeping meteors from falling to the ground, in the midst of large cities. That won't happen. Certainly, many must be wondering why we didn't intervene on other points, and I've talked about this before, and I'll repeat, there are situations that are up to you, directly, because you also need to know that you are capable. Start by stopping giving too much power to the outside and thinking that you are inferior to others, to the point of putting yourself completely in their hands. You need to look at your own potentials. And as I said, this is the year for it. The current viral situation, as I said, will be circumvented and is already being done. This will be when you least expect it, and in an abrupt way. The solution already exists and you need to know that it is about to manifest in physicality and you need to trust yourself, the light of your hearts, for that. Do not be afraid. You are not alone. Also don't discredit your body's ability, your spirit's potential to recalibrate, find solutions, and regenerate. This is the year of faith. As I said, you need to look and follow this faith. You will see. Summer. There were years when I feared for human reactions. I feared not because I was afraid of you, but because of what your levels of consciousness could do and trigger, harming yourself and others. Two world wars. Nuclear explosions. And here I am, as I promised, to prevent a third war, and so it will be. There won't be a third war, and no matter how hard they try, I give you my word, there will not be. Those who hold the warheads know about us. They all know of our presence. They know that we will not allow any warheads to be launched into another environment for mass destruction. This will not be allowed. And they will still try to do that. They will also try to make you believe that this has happened. But not. It won't happen. Indeed, it will not happen because I myself, Ashtar, am in charge of monitoring them. Can you disarm any warhead?
Oh yes, we can. I've done this. And I will do as many times as necessary.
And finally, dear ones, do not fear the pruning, the sorting, that is taking place. It is also necessary. It is fundamental. There is a frequency recalibration taking place all over the planet, in all dimensions. A signal has been sent from the galactic center for this, and it will move a lot of things around. There will really be a lot of stretch and pull, more dynamism, more novelties and changes in environments. You are being reborn, completely. Even though they are incarnated, they are being reborn. You are going through an ascension process while still in the material body, and everything has been felt, seen, perceived, and is a part of it. Many may think that reality is currently a little strange, and feel as if they are living a dream or something, and even more, as if they are not recognizing their own bodies. This, in many cases, is also part of the recalibration. You are being reborn and ascending to higher vibrations as the realities are also intertwining for final unity alignment. Calm down and enjoy the journey. It's all part of it. It's unprecedented in the galaxy, we've said it before. Just enjoy the ride and the view. And by the way, yes, some stars will look different in the near future. The journey from the solar system to Sirius continues. And we, as guardians, follow closely. As I've told you before, watch the dust on the road, and be ready to see more than you ever imagined when it completely subsides. Even though you are very informed about what has been happening, you will still be surprised about everything that is happening. Watch the dust. Watch. I am the voice of the Ashtar command, and I speak these truths. And so it is. Blessings. His brother. Ashtar. Adonai. Received by Raphael, Neva/Gabriel RL. Gratitude, beloved. Posted by Rev. Joshua Skirvin.